There we go. We're already getting.
Oh, maybe I should do the same.
Flip it.
We can all kind of just do it, whatever. Yeah, it's all.
There we go. Thing. All right, we're good. Yeah. We're live.
All right. We're live.
We're live, pal.
You guys see us too. Cool.
Jeez, someone just said a real bad word already.
We are live from the Tokyo Dome Hotel, room 3421. Oh, I don't know why I just gave
up. Why would you do that? You idiot. And we're live, pal. Yeah.
And we're live, pal. And we have a special guest who hasn't been with us. We got Cody Rhodes with us. I'm allowed to say it out here.
I was next door and I just walked in.
Yeah, that's how I was, just like last night.
Are you watching it live, Matt?
I'm watching it live, pal.
Oh, that's cool. You pulled a Ric Flair, you gave your room number away.
Yeah, I did. That was the classic.
Riverdale Road, Marriott.
We got Cody drinking our favorite coffee from
Speaking of Riverdale, you're a CW guy. I know you are, Cody.
Yeah.
Have you watched Riverdale?
I have.
Is it good?
It's
can you suggest it?
It's excellent. And it turns the source material. I don't know how many Archie Comics fans are left in the world.
Right.
I love the cast. But if you weren't
our generation.
If you weren't, you'll look back into it. It turns it kind of on its ear a little bit. Very good.
What show are we talking about?
Riverdale.
Yeah.
It's I've never heard of it.
It's set in the Archie universe, but it's kind of like a murder mystery now.
It's dark.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Dark, yeah.
On the CW.
I'm immediately interested. I'm just gonna tweet out the link for this thing and
tweet it out.
Yeah.
Where are we going to read these questions at? How are we going to read
You can use hashtag ask. I mean, it was the elite. It's the bullet club. But should it just be ask the elite still?
Yeah, just to keep it.
Hashtag
yeah.
ask the elite. Or if it lets you do questions on the old YouTube guy right there.
I can't see it.
I got my phone, though. So you can also leave questions and comments there. So go ahead and fire some off. Let me just click this off right here real quick.
Well, last night we had our first show for the tour. It went really well.
Went really good.
Yeah. I think
we were just talking about how banged up some of us are. Yeah. Cody was in there last night with Shibata. How would you think?
Yeah, maybe a bit off a little bit more than I could chew. No, it was really it's everything I thought it would be. I was just saying I don't understand why I was making noise as I was throwing forearms. We were referring to it as lugering.
Okay.
If you look at it, I'm literally going boom. With every shot.
I like that. You can hear everything kind of in the Japanese crowds because it gets kind of quiet. So people always say, like, me and Nick and Kenny especially, even you, Adam, you're really loud too.
We like
to do a lot of trash talk.
Not many people are
like,
vocal.
I love being vocal.
Yep.
But it makes it so fun for me to watch it back too.
I'd like to answer this question right off the bat. Someone says, where and when did the first famous Matt Jackson awkward stare down signing start? That was here in Japan.
And we had actually caught it on tape as well, and that's why it became a thing.
We get asked to do so many of these autographs because the fans kind of like, we call them lobby fans. They kind of just chill out there and they wait for us to come down. It gets kind of to the point where like you're like, I just got to entertain myself.
It's kind of a rib at this point because the same fans want autographs and they've gotten at least 100 each of them.
So one day I was just like, you know what?
Some of them don't even know who we are, but they just know the rest of us. So we get our autographs.
So I wanted to pop you guys. You two, that's what it was. And I just did it. And then it happened to be caught on film and then it just became my thing. So, and now I do meet and greets everywhere. And everyone's like, Matt, can you give me the weird stare down thing? And I'm cool with it. I do it. But then there's people who don't watch me in the elite, and they're just looking at me like I'm nuts. Like, what is that guy doing? You know what I mean?
And it's not that we were in a foul mood, but it's just like, enough with these guys.
I signed something as Cody Hall last night.
That's great.
The guy wouldn't give up on it. And I said, oh, that's not me. And I was, you know, and then I said it again, and then I realized it's going to take longer.
I was saying, you know, there are guys that don't know who we are. I've had so many times people hand me pictures of Tamatanga and say, like, please, please. I'm like, it's not me. But he's like, please.
What do you do?
I'm like, oh, okay.
Adam's got one
for everyone.
This is always, like, a interesting question, I think. If wrestling somehow didn't work out, what would you be doing as a profession?
Let's start with you, Adam.
That's a scary question.
Yeah.
Frightening.
God, that's so hard to... like picture. This is dorky, but in high school,
do you be a professional dipper?
Already a professional dipper. I don't know. I always liked in high school to do like, I was that dork that liked to do like school presentations where I spoke in front of the class.
Really?
Oh, like I that. Loved I doing it.
Doing
that. Yeah.
Mark Merrill,
loved doing it. Yeah, so something with I don't know, something with public speaking maybe.
Wow. Okay. That's good. Cool. How about you, Code?
I didn't know that.
I thought I had a knack for creative writing. So I always thought I'd be a comic book writer.
Oh, wow.
However,
wow. Too bad people couldn't creatively write for you.
Here we are. Five minutes in. Dark.
But I'm trying to change that.
I thought I could do well with it, and I actually recently like submitted this this one sheeter to every major comic book from the big to the little.
Yep.
Turned down. So maybe I'm not.
Beauty is in the eye of the beholder.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes it just takes the right set of eyes.
Power not. People didn't want it. It's pretty cool. There's
but this guy's already a super villain anyway, so he's already got something. He's already got
power. What about you, Kenny?
I really enjoy teaching, and that's one thing that I like to do, whether it be fitness related or something in school. I enjoy that, but I also have always wanted to try to be a pro gamer.
Oh, you are then.
I'm invited to pro tournaments. I practice with pro players and I do exhibition matches.
He's been humble.
But I mean, no. It takes a lot to make like top 32, top 16, top 8. But those are
What's the money like in that world?
Oh, it's huge now.
It's big,
yeah, if you're a winner,
if you're a top guy, right?
Yeah, you make a living.
Yeah.
Wow. Like the money is really in strategy games. You can make millions of dollars throughout your team and spread it out.
That's crazy.
But for fighting games, which is what I'm into and what I'm kind of talented at, I mean, the pots are 250 grand, 500 grand. Yeah.
That's awesome. Ooh.
Who
would have tried basketball, but I was never tall enough. But that's what I would have tried.
I don't even have an answer. I have no idea. I would own a coffee shop or something. I don't know.
Right. That's really tough. We were just talking about that last night, how tough it is to imagine
a
9-to-5.
It's frightening. Yeah. Someone says, will the awkwardness ever end between Cole and Omega?
It's awkward. I don't know.
Yeah.
I think everything's cool now. I think.
I don't know. I guess publicly it's fine to say, but I was it was like heat of the moment yesterday.
Right.
Like it's not.
Yeah.
I think we're fine.
Yeah. I'll be the first to say it. I have a little bit of an ego.
We all do,
you know?
I think you're two very strong alpha males.
Jinx.
Yep.
Leaders. So there's always going to be a little
That's
bit
true.
Of
I feel like we
professional
are both leaders.
I don't know the word I'm looking
I've
for.
Always been a leader in Japan, and for Cole to be the leader of ROH and come on in, it's like who should close the show?
Right.
Who am I to say?
Right.
It's not my place. I'm sorry.
In the midst
of
the album talk.
Uh-oh.
Maybe lightens the mood. I had two alpha female pugs.
Oh,
you know, and they scratch.
Cool. Yeah,
they scratch each other's eyes out.
You sent me pictures.
I met the alpha female. That counts, right?
I don't know, like, but they scratch each other's eyes out.
You know what I'm talking about?
No.
She's a worker, anyway.
All right, let's pull some boys.
Yeah, get some more questions up.
Someone meant to say, okay, how big is barista's dick? I think you meant Batista.
I was going to say, well, actually, the females will serve me the coffee.
That comes up every two days.
We were there earlier, right? I don't know if that.
There was not a male barista.
I think
in
it was
house,
a female
so.
Barista this morning at old Choco Crow.
Yeah, it was. It was. It's a great question.
Oh, Lord. Okay, let's see. When will we see the Young Bucks versus the Revival?
Oh,
I knew that was going to come up. That's like a hot topic right now. I don't know. Probably never.
When pigs fly or what?
Well, we're under a deal for another year and like 8 months, so it's not going to happen anytime soon.
No, not anytime soon. I would love to wrestle them.
Unless they were open over there to work with who we're working with right now, which
right.
I think
I don't
is
think
the way business should be done is special events like that.
It'd be cool. I mean, if there were there were special events that allowed for cross promotional
stuff,
it'd
be awesome.
It would
be
interesting.
Great.
Yep.
I think we're heading that direction.
I hope so.
It feels like it is.
Yeah. It feels like the business is changing.
It still feels like we're close, but it still feels like before something could ever solidify, it would be like 2 to 3 years
right.
in the future.
Yeah, you're
still.
Right.
It's like
we
we're open. It's almost like both sides are open to the idea. The talent is definitely open to the idea.
Oh, the talent for sure.
But it's just putting pen to paper and actually making it happen.
Last year we tried very hard for New Day Elite. And both sides worked very hard, but it just didn't happen.
No, it didn't pan out.
But the positive part of that was that we made kind of new friendships.
Yeah. And fun videos.
A lot of sweet merch.
We stole a lot of sweet merch ideas.
This is kind of a good one because it's so appropriate for you guys, Bucks. And this can be for everybody.
Mm-hmm.
This is for you, though, Matt.
Yep.
but everyone. What's your favorite wrestling merch that isn't your own?
Oh, like, wow.
What's your favorite wrestling merchandise?
Of all time?
Yeah.
I know what mine is immediately. Time. I picked up a Tiger Hattori t-shirt days ago at Backdrop, and it's my favorite shirt maybe ever. I love it. I love it.
Mine is the APA shirt, always pounding ass.
Is that a real shirt?
Real shirt that was released. APA, always pounding ass.
WWE released that?
WWE released that shirt.
Way.
My all-time favorite wrestling t-shirt ever released.
Oh, I can't top that.
Jeez.
APA.
Yeah, well, I mean, when I was a kid, I don't know why, but I always thought it was really funny that Owen came out with the 316 shirt, I just broke your neck.
Oh,
like, who would actually
release
a shirt that said that? But recently, the one shirt that really, that wasn't ours,
mm-hmm.
That I thought was ingenious was the Too Sweet or Delete, or like, it was the Elite, but then the D.
That
is
ingenious. You know what? I found out that's not even a Matt Hardy t-shirt. Some fans made that.
Oh, really?
That's cool. Matt Hardy should do that.
It was still really good. Yeah, I was like, wow, that's, you know, finally we're getting it spun around on us.
Yeah, right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, right.
We
Perry.
What
about you, Code?
I'm a classic NWO shirt.
Oh,
I was going to say that.
I was going to spray paint in my own.
Oh, yeah, same here.
Did you see the Wolfpack shirt like getting hot right now with one of the Jenners or girls was
wearing on the walkway a little bit. The Wolfpack shirt.
Someone
did you backyard guy? Did you backyard?
I wouldn't call it backyard because it was in the basement.
Oh,
but
basement
fed.
Yeah.
But we had the luxury of having a couple legitimate titles.
Great.
Yeah. So I had
what a prop to have
the NWA USA Six Man Tag Team Championships.
That's awesome.
One of the television titles.
Jeez.
Yeah, it was good stuff. But
cool.
I found out early on that you cannot be the booker and all the champions.
and
your friends keep coming over.
You probably had enough of that at WWE
Someone asked you, Cody, how has the change been from going to WWE to the Independents?
That's a good question.
That's like no hyperbole. This has been the most fun I've ever had. In my career. I was telling somebody with Wrestle Kingdom, like, I think it was about 10 minutes I was out there. It's the most fun I ever had. And they legit, it was one of those I didn't want it to end.
Mm-hmm.
So I went out, jumped on the dugout.
Right.
All the young boys were trying to get me down. And like, I didn't want to leave. Like,
that's
I just
cool.
was having such a good time. So it's
good.
Been really, really welcoming.
Good.
Good.
Yeah.
Good. Glad to hear that.
All right, let's see. I got a couple more over here. Who's the funniest out of all of you guys?
Oh, my God.
Pretty
hard.
Us working as a tandem
so
is what
yeah.
you know. It complements each other. So
I gotta say, I always say Kenny cracks me up the most.
But I'll say this: if we're hanging out, we're pretty much laughing the whole time.
Yeah,
yeah. There are things that Kenny does, that Matt does, that Nick like.
Yeah, we all have our own little things.
You know, I'm gonna say it right now. I think whoever's the grumpiest or in the most bitter mood is the funniest that day.
Right,
that's
right.
How it works out.
Cody has
it's always usually a tie between like me and you.
Right.
You know?
Yeah, right.
But sometimes when Nick is mad, he's
really
funny.
Nick,
it's
when
so
Nick's
rare.
Angry?
Yeah, it's hilarious.
Nick went nuts the other day when we were at a hotel. It was an ROH weekend, and the hotel person was like, well, check-in is until 3, and Nick just went crazy. And Frankie Kazarian and Chris Daniels were us, and they're like, your brother's insane.
Those little things though, like we leave on a red eye every time, so we don't sleep that night.
Need a hotel.
Yeah, so it's 10 hours of travel without sleep, and we get to the hotel at 9, 10 a.m. and it's like, oh, well, you can't check in for 3 or 4 more
hours.
One
thing I'll say,
I'm gonna be mad.
Yeah,
but that's it.
Well, just say one thing I'll say is that like 9 times out of 10, we're thrust into a situation that we're not happy with.
Yeah,
and Matt and I will be so grumpy.
Yes.
And we always kind of lean on Nick to be the guy.
He's always
on the fake smile.
He's always the one that kind of does it while we're just
right.
Like,
we're trailing 30 feet behind, just shaking our heads.
But on that same part, I'll be the one that yells at the guy too.
That's true.
That's true. Nick can flip the script a little bit.
I guess you could say.
What is your favorite childhood toy?
Oh. A Hulk Hogan. I think it might have been this one. The
LJN.
What position was he at? Was it like this?
I don't remember. Oh, you're thinking about the Hasbro, I think.
Maybe the Hasbro.
Yeah.
But one of those ones.
Yeah. I got the most out of my trampoline because that was where the backyard wrestling
you got the most
started.
Out of it, right?
Yeah, like I used that more than anything.
We had a wrestling ring at like, I was like 12 years old, so
I was 16,
I'd probably say that.
For me, like, maybe it was the turtle lair.
Oh yeah, those.
Oh yeah, those are the sewer setup. Yeah,
that's a good one.
Because I use that not only with my Ninja Turtle figures, but every kind of figure.
You brought them into the world.
Exactly.
Yeah. Smart.
And I had like setups and storyline crossovers, and I would film them. It was pretty cool. Great. Yeah.
Castle Grayskull.
I was gonna say the second place for me was the Thundercats lair.
Oh yeah. So it was nice to cross the. Across the streams.
Yeah.
Bring so in a different toy. Yeah.
Hey, someone says, hey, when is Adam Cole coming to Santiago, Chile? And maybe soon.
I don't know if we could say anything.
Maybe we can't exactly say when, but very, very soon. You might be seeing the Super Click there. Yeah. That'll be fun. And you actually might be seeing this guy over here, too.
Get a big discussion. Yeah.
Maybe you'll see all four of us
over here. We had a big discussion about Chile last night. Yeah. We have concerns.
Yeah. We took Cody to a sponsor last night at TGIF Friday, our favorite Japanese restaurant.
It's always sponsored for us. People are probably like, these guys are so
sweet. Videoed a little bit of it, so it'll be on the next Being the Elite. We should actually probably be shooting some stuff for Being the Elite right now.
Yeah, you probably should shoot videos.
Some behind the scenes type of stuff.
Yeah.
But Masa, of course, was there. Masa got stopped yesterday on the way into the restaurant by a fan from West Covina, California. He's like, "Oh my God, Masa!" And he started marking out.
You're
for
famous
Masa.
Now.
I heard famous on YouTube, and Masa's like blushing. Masa said that it's been overwhelming response from like the last video. I think the last Being the Elite was 37 was like my favorite one, the funniest one. Maybe.
It was a good time. It's up there. I think if we went back and watched them all, it would make a top five.
I watched like 1 through 10 the other day to just kind of go back. I'm like, man, it feels like we've been doing this forever. It's been fun.
When did you guys officially start?
Maybe a little over a year ago, right? That's it.
Our YouTube channel's a year now,
right?
But Being the Elite series has been probably about 8 months.
Even less, because that was an idea you came up with.
Yeah.
Even
I'm glad we ran with it.
Where did Adam Cole get that?
There it is.
Beanie.
There it is.
No. Yeah.
That
oh no. Swerve, huh?
What is it? It is a swerve.
Is that a debit shirt?
Where did Adam Cole get the debit shirt?
But it's spelled Deviant?
Yeah, Deviant shirt.
No,
this is
a Deviant shirt?
This is Suplex Wrestling. Joel will be really happy.
But you know what, Adam? You don't answer the real question.
Yeah,
Address the elephant in the room. What is that bump on your head, Adam?
That's a fucking elephant on your fucking skull, man.
I'm just going to tell the real story, and it's not exciting at all. But just because it's brought up multiple times a day for months now.
Every day.
Literally.
How long do you got left?
Literally every day.
Yeah. Let the people know.
Yeah, I'm not dying. I got punched in the head in Detroit. It swelled up. Mm-hmm. It hasn't gone down.
By Dalton Castle.
Took the heat out. Dalton Castle punched me in the head.
Yeah.
It wasn't even like a punch, though. It was like a chop.
It was almost like a backhand chop.
It swelled up, hasn't gone down. It needs to be surgically removed. Mm-hmm. I just haven't gotten time to get it cut off yet.
You haven't had time
to go under and get it cut off.
You're going in soon,
in the next couple weeks.
I'm in the same boat, but it's fine.
I don't think surgery get mine cut off yet either. I plan to. It's in the books.
I've had people literally DM me and write me and go, "Is Adam all right? Is he dying?
Weird.
Yeah, is Adam. I'm like, I don't say anything because I didn't know if you wanted me to.
Either. Right,
but
right.
There it is, everybody.
I'm glad it's out there.
It's over.
I think the whole time I've known him, he's had it.
Since
October. Yeah, it's been on there. It's been a while. So yeah.
I mean, I noticed it quite quickly because I had a friend that had the exact same thing.
And it was
the exact same thing. He had to get it surgically removed, but there was no health risk.
Zero health risk.
Just
a cosmetic thing.
Right. Besides Cracker Barrel, what other restaurants do you like to eat while traveling? Cracker Barrel is the greatest restaurant in the world.
It is.
Are you a Cracker Barrel guy?
I had a moment at a Cracker Barrel which just scared me away from them forever.
Are you gonna ruin it for me?
Well, no, it was not Cracker Barrel itself. It was who I went to Cracker Barrel with.
Sure.
Most people can figure out who this story is about, but they requested their oatmeal not be runny at Cracker Barrel, and they were really explicit in the directions. Like, you know what I mean by runny? Like, I don't want to see what, like, almost rude enough.
Right, yeah.
So I went, you know, whatever, I'm just minding my own business. Of course, the oatmeal comes, it's runny, such and such, grabs the oatmeal, and you know those picket wood things in between each section? Picks it up, throws it across the restaurant full speed, smashes against the thing. I just got up, walked to the car, Just waited about 20 minutes and
watched the fireworks.
And I saw him take a few pictures with some people on the way out, and then that was my.
As he left, Cracker Barrel was on fire.
Yeah,
there was no arrest made or anything.
No. I feel like it somehow was fixed, but it scared me away from Cracker Barrel.
I see
why.
I understand. Yeah. That's a shame because Cracker Barrel's the greatest.
It was Ted DiBiase Jr.
I like how he just all mixed.
Based on the story you were telling us last night, I was kind of
it actually wasn't, but I feel like
we'll just use a placeholder for the story.
Any other favorites we like to go to the Rug Guys? Any?
You know what? There is a. I don't even know why I'm speaking because I don't even know the name. I think it's called the Protein Shack. Is that what it is?
Protein Shack.
I don't know if that it sounds.
It's like an East Coast thing.
Mm. Protein Shack.
Protein something. My friend in the East Coast. And I saw that you're wearing a Creator Pro shirt. So those guys.
Muscle Maker Grill.
Muscle Maker. That's what
Muscle
it is. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Grill.
I've never even heard.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
It's really good.
Yeah. What do they got there?
Okay.
Just everything that you need to become lean and jacked.
Really? Wow.
Yeah. All right, it's all food conscious for like bodybuilders and guys that are trying to stay in shape, but like the taste of their food as well.
Is it a chain of it?
I'm a Denny's guy.
It's kind of
Denny's. Denny's is reliable.
I love Outback. I love Chili's.
Oh, yeah. Outback Steakhouse. Oh yeah.
Applebee's is a place.
Oh, Applebee's is my favorite.
Side story about Outback Steakhouse. We'll say it was Ted DiBiase.
Yeah.
A girl came up to the group of us at a table and said that she wanted an autograph, and the same person who did the oatmeal thing said. He had a thing of the little like shiitake mushrooms. He said, "If you pour these mushrooms on your head, I'll give you an
Who
autograph."
Is this?
We thought, oh, that's too much. Oh, that's not gonna happen.
Waiting for the I'm joking.
Of course, she did it, and then I've never felt more terrible in my life. Another moment where I got up and went to the car.
Yeah. And now you can't eat there.
Wasn't concerned with the bill.
Now you can't eat there. That's
crazy.
Someone, Ted DiBiase Jr. But it wasn't.
Someone asked, "Are we going to see all five of you in the same PWG show sometime in the future?"
Oh,
that'd be awesome.
God, that would be awesome.
That would be very difficult. But that aside from this place, that's maybe the most possible venue for it to happen.
Yeah.
That or ROH.
ROH,
I could see that.
Yeah.
That'd be one expensive match, huh?
Yeah.
Just between this guy's guarantee.
Ten man,
the Ted DiBiase senior laugh there.
Okay.
Everyone's got a price.
If you could choose any wrestler, past or present, to join the Bullet Club, who would you pick? Hollywood Hogan.
Yeah.
There was talks about Hollywood Hogan coming here and being with the Bullet Club like a year ago.
Before Adam.
That's what I was competing with, right?
It was Hogan.
Yeah.
Kurt Angle, Jeff Hardy,
or me,
or Adam Cole.
No, I came up with Adam Cole.
Yeah. We all did.
Yeah,
did
you say Kurt Angle too?
I think
Kurt Angle.
Yeah. That name was thrown out.
Yeah. And I was like, how about Adam Cole? You know, something a little more realistic.
I feel like, why is Hogan not in the Bullet Club?
Yeah, right. At least for a night. Like,
so it would be amazing.
I actually wanted all those guys, like the original core dudes, just to come out, even if it was for.
Yes.
Yeah. Just to walk us out.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Like at a Tokyo Dome or something, just for an entrance.
I've been amazed by, I have dived back in watching old Hogan matches.
Yep.
Hulk Hogan is the king of pantomime.
Oh, yeah.
He's really good.
Yeah.
We were just talking about
the farthest guy out there.
The genius, right?
Yeah.
Awesome.
That's right.
Bro, that's so funny.
It's a World War III or something, and he's explaining that he didn't go over the top, and he's literally all four sides sliding under the bottom. And even like Beefcake's face, like not being hit. He's doing like this big.
Everyone knows what he's saying,
bro.
Everyone.
If I was to like get a chance to talk with him now, I'd literally ask like, "Who trained you?" Because it's the farthest row, the very back. Yep. They know what. They know.
Universally, everyone knows what he's speaking.
Blows my mind. The king talking about Sid. He's doing this on the way to the ring.
Yep.
It's the king of pantomime. Yeah. Everything.
He was awesome.
Yeah.
He was awesome.
Hulk's like he's underrated for some certain things. That people like to go, he wasn't a great wrestler. He was, you know what? That's all part of wrestling. That's all part of it.
Yeah.
And he was cool. And he liked our work. So you know what? That's another reason why I like him.
And I hate the argument where they say, "Oh, Vince could have pushed anyone." No.
No way.
It had to have been Hulk Hogan. It had to have been.
Hulk Hogan's the man.
He is the man.
I feel like if you're one of those like people who are like, well, technically, you're an asshole.
Right.
Hulk Hogan is the man.
The entire package of Hulk Hogan is
Hulk Hogan.
Yeah.
Someone says, who's the most athletic member of the Bullet Club? Nick Jackson.
Yeah, it's Nick.
his thing.
Yeah. Come on. That's everything comes really effortlessly for him.
He can do anything.
I'm blushing.
Yeah. Nick, was it you who did the dive at PWG that we were talking about last
time? Yeah, that's right. Yeah. I hit the lamp on top.
Our WrestleMania ladder match.
No, you're talking
about that one. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. That's a great story. That's a great story.
Our WrestleMania ladder match. Somebody wanted to steal a dive that they had seen at PWG.
Oh, Jesus.
And
I remember this.
Oh, Jesus.
There was
well, yeah, I text you right away.
There, there were concerns whether they could do it or not. So a group of us, pretty much everyone in that match, is hovering around a tiny phone trying to watch this one.
That's right.
Brilliant moment.
We were talking about this last night.
It was executed, though.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah,
yeah.
It was good.
Yeah.
It was good. It was fine, but it's like, I mean, there were so many moments when I'll get a GIF sent to me and be like, hey, buddy,
a GIF,
buddy,
or a GIF,
a GIF,
yeah.
And they send me, they send it to me and say, check out what was ripped off of yours lately. I'll never get mad because at this point, I just know it's gonna be something that looks like maybe 20% of
what you did.
Yeah, but it's just like I just want to see who did it, you know.
Right.
And then what guy's on Fed TV is going to claim that they did it first?
You can't steal anymore, yeah, man.
No, it's kind of disrespectful.
The world's too small.
Everyone knows everyone now. So it's like, why would you steal something, rename it, claim that it's yours, and then kind of run with that? I don't know.
I steal stuff from anyone I tagged with. That's my rule.
Okay.
Or like Bob Holly.
We'll change a match today.
Anyone I tagged with, I feel like it's really okay to steal their thing, but I always call it their thing.
It's
their move.
Yeah, especially when you're calling the match, and then I'll hit your move right here.
The thing is, if I ever do rip off a move and steal it directly from a guy, I'm not gonna rename it like, oh, this is Kenny's curse or whatever. You know what I mean? I'll at least give the guy, you know, the credit for
right, that sure.
Like you guys call the super kick a super kick. You don't call
of course.
It.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah,
the,
that's true.
The like the.
We just.
I don't know what else you would call it.
Wait.
I want to see
the Young Bucks thrust.
Yeah.
Someone asked me and Nick,
that
how
sounds like it'd be a good point and click adventure game. But.
How excited are you to come to TJ Mexico for the Crash? We're going to Tijuana. That was just.
Oh.
Now.
Okay. Okay.
I'm excited. I'm pumped. I'm hearing a lot of buzz about the company, the Crash. Conan's been trying to get us down there for a while, so it'll be fun.
We haven't been to Mexico in
not
almost.
Since,
actually, more than a decade.
Yeah, not since the midgets were finger banging each other's in the butts and
backstage
in the locker room. Yeah, that's a story we told on
we'll
the Kevin Steen
that.
Show.
Yeah, we'll have
yeah.
To tell
wow.
Them.
So yeah, I'm sorry to just leave you with that, but that happened. Yeah, that was the last time we were there.
Wow.
We've kind of been afraid to go back. So
it'll
be interesting.
It'll be fun though.
I'm
excited
for it.
For it.
Let's see.
Do we want to? This one's kind of
please
entertaining.
Yeah, please.
Worst match of your career for everybody.
Oh, we were just talking about this recently.
Our worst match?
Oh, yeah. I had just broke my rib. Matt had just broke his hand. And it was our first match back.
Oh,
and we
right.
came back way too soon, so we were still injured. It was, Trent Barretta and Rocky Romero.
They were
on a 30-day tour. And the next day, they flew to Ring of Honor to do a three-way tag with us.
Oh, my God.
And what was the 13? It might have been Rhett and Kenny.
Yeah, Rhett and Kenny.
And we were all just there, and we didn't want to work at all. And we were hurt. And it was just...
And it was one of those matches where you're out there, and you're just going... You're 12 minutes out there, and you're like, this match sucks. Holy
it sucked.
And it kept going on. Like, those matches are the worst because they never end. They just keep going.
Because,
like, even if a bad match is 8 minutes, you go, well, it was only 8 minutes. We were like 25 minutes.
It felt like it.
Maybe 20.
I think that was, in recent memory, that was our worst.
Right.
Hmm. Mine was my first Ring of Honor dark match, years ago, where I did this tag. It was supposed to be 6 minutes, and I get tagged in for my hot tag, and I'm in there bumping and feeding a guy. And you guys remember the Dark City Fight Club?
Yep. Of course.
They came out and they said, we're sorry, not planned, and just started beating the hell out of us.
Not planned. You know, this was a thing that happened.
Yeah.
They got sent out?
Whenever there was a dark match and it was going long, Pierce would go, "Send Dark City!" Adam Pierce is the booker. Right. "Send Dark City! Send Dark City!"
And it wasn't like we were 12 minutes right. in and the hot tag happened. Mm-hmm. It was like, I got tagged in for the hot tag, and the second the 6 minutes hit, he was like, "Send him!
Send Dark City!" He would yell.
They sent them out and like beat the hell out of us, and we got to the back, and we got reamed out by multiple people, and I at one point got screamed at in my face. I'm 19 years old, and they went, "I swear on everything that I own, you will never work for Ring of Honor again."
And now you're a three-time champion.
I remember thinking my career was over at 19.
That's scary.
That's number
did
one
you,
for me.
Did you cry at all after that?
I don't remember. I think I was so sad that I was emotionless. Yeah, like, I was like a zombie. Yeah, I was just like, oh, my life's over, okay. And then I didn't feel anything. Right. I don't think I cried, but yeah, I was so sad.
Okay, I don't want the story to be long because I don't even remember the guy's name, but there is a local Californian dude. He never worked for PWG. He worked for whatever another reputable promotion.
AWS?
Yes, that's the one.
Okay.
So he worked for that, and there are a lot of these guys that wanted to be like enhancement talent for Jeff Katz's production.
Okay, yep.
And they would all work out in the ring before the show, and we were each able to handpick a guy to have an enhancement match against. So I didn't really care because I just figured, you know, this is me being overly cocky. Perfect. Give me anybody and I'll have a decent match with them. So it's no big deal. So I let, you know, everyone kind of pick their guy first. And I said, okay, who are we left with? And I had like a choice of three guys. I said, okay, whatever, this guy. He said, and when I had said this guy, he had just taken a really nice high like hip toss bump. And not that I do hip tosses, but I was like, yeah, it looks like he knows what he's doing.
Yeah,
looks
sure.
coordinated,
sure.
athletic enough to get up for a hip toss. Anyway, we had the match, and this is kind of one of those sort of like Lucha Underground-esque promotions where, like, you know, there's creative camera angles, there's some cuts in between some of the spots and stuff. So I thought, worst comes to worst, we'll be able to cut it up and it'll look fine. But this guy, and he was such a, like, a fan, and he knew all my stuff, and I guess that is what cursed the match, was because he would go against the grain to like work against me, and it's one thing to sack out on a move or to not know how to take it and it looks bad, but like when you're kind of literally working against the other person,
right,
it makes it look worse than even like a botch could look, if
sure.
that makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah,
so it's just like a disaster of a match.
Yeah It's like, yeah, if you want a German suplex a guy and he's heavy,
yeah,
sometimes it'll still look good. But when a guy wet noodles you, that's the worst.
So
you know?
Had a couple of bad experiences at that company. Would you
yep.
be okay telling the story?
Of course.
You know what I'm talking about.
A couple things.
Yeah, not the glass shattering.
No. Oh, okay.
Was there a moment with your testicles, Kenny?
Yeah, there was.
Are you okay talking
about it? Yeah, I could. I think I just told this on Talk is Jericho, so I could go over it quickly again.
If you don't mind.
Yeah.
I think it's hilarious.
Yeah. There's a spot or whatever where we were going to I was gonna get rid of a guy out to the floor, and then I was gonna go do like a dive feint.
Yeah.
And just like do a deal where, you know, you feint the dive and do a backflip.
Mm-hmm.
This is like my ninth segment of the day. So I do the backflip, and I swear to goodness, I didn't mean to do this on purpose, but I kind of landed like how Ricochet and Ospreay land.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Not purposely.
Yeah.
So I was like, whatever. I landed it, and it looks cool enough. And this is in 2011 before
everyone
was doing
it. Like the superhero landing?
Landing before it was a superhero landing.
Yes.
So like, I can run with this. No big deal. And then I stand up, and I'm all like, you know, come on, come back in the ring. And then Tommy Dreamer was like, cut. And I'm like, fuck Tommy. I was like, I know it. I'm like standing up, I'm like, Tommy. And I was like, I know I didn't stick the landing perfectly, but everything else was so good. And he's like, no, that's not it. And I'm like, what? And he's like, your balls are hanging out, man. And I look, and I'm just kind of like, kind of grab like my tights with my index finger, and kind of like, you know?
This is in front of a live audience.
Yeah, live audience. And they're just like paid extras, so they're cheering
right.
for the, you know, and they're just sort of like, you know, like, yeah. And they're kind of like this, like, and I think Tommy they're laughing at me just because Tommy kept saying cut, because it was taking a while for the match to get on track anyway.
How funny.
And it was like the finals of this big feud that I was having. So I thought like, okay, we're going to do a bunch of cuts.
Blow off match.
Yeah.
Balls out.
Anyway, and that was all because we did the spot where like
he went balls out.
The guy powders to the corner, and then when you go to approach him, he grabs your tights and pulls you into the button, right?
Yeah.
So he went to grab my tights, but he grabbed actually the inside of my...
I think you said he grabbed your actual balls.
No. Yeah, and that's how you... No, so you grabbed the inside, and I guess we pulled it. It sort of shifted everything out. And I didn't even notice.
You know, that's what... Yeah. You guys heard where Ryder ripped the local guy's trunks completely
Yes,
off.
I remember hearing about that. Ripped him completely off. Yeah, he was completely naked.
No,
yes, yes.
Ripped him completely off. And then instead of like, you know what? This is dark, and it's not on TV. Ryder's commitment to, I'm going to show them my stuff.
No.
He went ahead and hit, at the time, I don't know if his finish was the Rough Ryder, but he goes all the way through.
Yeah.
Like, the guy is literally like just begging for a roll-up.
That's
embarrassing. Yeah. It's all...
And he's naked. Yeah. What a legend.
Yeah. I thought he would get a job for that. Like,
he'd
be the naked dude. Yeah.
What's your worst match? Yeah.
Oh, it's dreadful. It's we call it the pump handle and the dunk.
Okay.
Is what we use as our hashtag for it.
this is a thing.
Yeah.
Just amongst yourselves.
It was a SmackDown match between myself, Wade Barrett, Daniel Bryan, and Ezekiel Jackson.
Mm-hmm.
Oh no, it's a six man actually. Who else? Oh, Ted DiBiase Jr. is with us.
Man, this guy, I would hang out with
him. Yeah. Salt of the earth. And then the original Sin Cara, who there were some issues with, just language wise.
Yep.
And also it got to the point.
Nailing your spots wise.
Well, you know. What you know when you like get a reputation. And like all of a sudden nobody wants to work with you anymore.
Yeah,
but then
you
you almost want to reverse it. Where you're like, well, we still got matches to do, so let's
sure.
Of course.
Something along the lines of like Wade scoops him up for this pump handle slam, he slides behind. That was gonna be the big tag to Zeke.
Oh yeah, that's good.
And then Zeke was gonna, you know, get shut down, and then Daniel Bryan, who has not yet hit the Yes Mania, but still people love Dan.
Yes.
He's gonna make this big fiery comeback, and he's finally gonna get a win, because for a long time Dan.
Oh my god! Earthquake!
Is it an earthquake?
We just had that happen.
We're good.
We, for no reason, the phone just fell from our tripod. Did you crack your screen?
No, I'm alright. My $1,200 freaking iPhone. It's alright.
That happened for no reason.
Yeah.
Right.
That literally happened for no reason.
You're good. We're good.
There's no draft.
We're back?
Yeah, we're back.
We're live, pal.
go ahead, Cody.
That was scary, though.
Anyways, Wade picks him up for the pump handle. Sin lands behind him, and for whatever reason, just kicks Stu right in the balls. And, like, he kicks him right in the balls. And this is one of those moments where there's supposed to be, like, some element of, like, need. But now he's just standing right up on his feet. And Stu, professional as he was, because he could have murdered him, picks him up one more time, lands him behind him, one more. Kick right to the balls. Stu literally just pretends, comes over, tags me, and this is what happens. He forgets to tag Zeke.
Okay.
And instead tags Dan. Now, Dan, being the professional he is, can do anything.
Of course.
Right. Yeah. And Teddy, they're competent. They've worked a ton together. So Zeke is like, you can see him frustrated.
Right.
Because this was his moment.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And anyways, Dan does the corner dropkick, the very first one. He's literally... duck, clothesline, backflip. We ended up doing the corner dropkick.
Wow.
I mean, he's just getting rolling into like Daniel Bryan stuff, and cover, one, two, three, and
holy crap.
And like, it's so the match is over. Zeke is just this. Dan almost, he sits up and then goes,
easy payday, right?
Like that's how wrestlers should.
So I roll out and I'm thinking, hey, I'm talking to Stu, who's right here, and I said, why don't we go get some heat on him? Let's salvage this.
Sure,
let's go get. But by the time I get done saying, hey, why don't we go? He's already stormed to the back. He's literally not there anymore. Which then the greatest line of the night ever is we walk through the curtain and the boss stands up and, hey, he didn't kick out. And
Tommy Lee Jones, or
Tommy Lee Jones. Yeah.
Can you get that one?
And Ted, of course. Ted Jr. Says, and I'll never forget it. It just like echoes in my mind. He says, "Where is that referee? He was trying to fuck on me." And like everyone just
eat on the ref.
That's so great.
That's good. That's so good.
In fairness, he did kick out.
Yeah.
But because your referees can't block the hard cam.
Right.
He wasn't in position, so they were both kind of right in this situation. Yes.
What a nightmare.
Yeah, and they didn't edit any of it. Was the worst part. Oh, it's SmackDown.
It's
It'll
funny.
All
be- oh, come on, man. You know what's crazy? Right. How often that happens on that television, where there's three counts when there shouldn't be. I'm blown away.
There was a while where referees were bonused if they if you didn't kick out or if you didn't
but
break
counted
one
to
five.
Three.
Yeah.
Oh, so it's like
Yeah.
Wow.
That's crazy. I see. Yes. So there's almost an incentive to try to fast count a guy to get some money.
Yeah. Thus, you know the referee fucking on.
Right. He's like, yeah.
This is a good question. Craziest bump you've ever taken?
Oh my gosh.
I already know Nick's. I know Kenny's, I think, too, maybe.
Yeah, probably.
The run off the top.
Yeah, of course.
That was what I was thinking, too.
Yeah,
Bushi's at the
Budokan. Yeah.
Yeah. I've taken some
Nick's at in the ladder
match. Ladder match,
that
right?
That might have been.
Yeah.
Really Nick was on the top of the ladder, and what everyone came from the bottom and held up the ladder and just walked,
ooh,
and then dumped Nick through one
I've
table.
I've done some stupid stuff, though.
Yeah.
I remember, like, 12 years ago, maybe even longer, I did a flip the swanton off the top of the cage to the floor. Remember that?
Whoa.
That was stupid.
My craziest
in front of 100 people.
In TNA, we had two ladders and then a table on top.
We're cursed.
That's a crack for sure.
No, I'm good.
Really?
We're cursed.
Wow. But are we live?
Should we
now
just hold it? Vibrating the phone and making it fall from the tripod.
I got to text her, Matt.
I'll text her.
Oh, good idea. Yeah.
Yeah, please stop calling Nick.
Yeah.
Because it.
Q&A.
We're not.
She keeps screwing it up, I think.
Oh, okay.
All right, we're live now.
Okay. Yeah, makes she know what she's causing.
It's a complete habit here.
Everyone's saying, it keeps hanging up.
I remember when I was, like, when I landed.
Was there injury at all?
Oh, no, my knees, they were a little swollen afterwards, but I remember just feeling like I almost died, and then having that weird, feel like I was scared, but I was, like, my body was shaking afterwards, because I was I almost landed.
Yeah,
I landed kind of on my face, you know, Kenny?
Of course,
was like that.
Of course.
So I was like
415 flat.
Before. Yeah.
I'm shocked that didn't crack.
It, the top of it kind of did earlier, he said.
Mine was moonsault off a cage.
Oh, okay.
Moonsault off a cage.
Yeah.
Kurt Angle style?
Yeah. I did one with Cesaro in the garden, and it went, like, perfectly. And then I did another one on Brawl TV that didn't go perfectly. And, like,
what happened on the one that didn't go
perfectly? I just missed. It's the best way to put it.
I don't know how you can
have
the courage to climb up the top of one of those things and do that. Like, I've been on top of a cage, and I'm like, this is insane.
Mm-hmm.
How do people...
It's hilarious when you look at it, like, from here to there, and you're like, oh, it's nothing. But then when you get up there, it's...
It's frightening.
Just a terrifying
thing. And Kurt would do it every year for, like, 10 years. You do DNA, like, multiple times.
I had a cage match with Kurt on Friday.
You do? He's going to want to do that?
Yeah, on Friday.
He's going to want to do it.
I don't think he's going to want to do it.
He's crazy.
He's
in the best way possible.
He's full speed, man. He's full speed.
How have your guys' matches been at What Culture? You guys have done...
I really enjoyed the What Culture match.
Yeah.
I also enjoy it because up front, like, it's not, like, technical, cool wrestling, but I did a cartwheel, and the UK fans jump right on the tin stuff, and it was fun to look at Kurt and him discover...
Right.
Like, I don't know if he knows who Ty Dillinger is, but, like...
Right,
he was like, I want to
they're saying the stream is dead. I'm worried that the stream is actually dead because I'm getting a bunch of messages to.
Oh, we're talking for no reason right now.
Yeah,
let me check.
Yeah. I got a couple. Like,
no, we're
fast,
live.
Rapid fire. Okay, fast rapid fire question.
Go for it, baby.
Favorite Marvel villain.
Ooh.
I just want to get it out there because I want to see him in a movie. Fast. It's Mr. Sinister.
Good.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm gonna give the YouTube audience.
You got his last name.
Some love.
Some love. So I'm going to read some questions off there.
Okay.
So if you guys want to ask some questions on the comment section right now, I'll...
Can you even get see the comments?
Let's do a... Yeah.
Street Fighter asked a question here. I just want to answer.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, go ahead.
Street Fighter guy. Is Yuri in a top 8 Street Fighter 5 character? Yes, he is top 3, in fact. So just so you know, he's cheap. That's why I don't play him. I play Zed tier.
All right, let's do some rapid fire ones, guys.
Go for it.
All right, let's see. Are you guys excited for What Culture Pro?
Yeah.
What's our match on that one?
Yeah.
Is that Strong Style?
No, you won't be there, Kenny. You won't be on
that one. It'll this be the March one that the four of us are doing.
I'm not excited then.
All right, favorite.
We have a special shirt coming out. Can we talk about that?
Yeah.
We got a special What Culture Bullet Club shirt coming out. It'll be available on the show. Yeah.
Favorite song, guys?
Gangster's Paradise.
Under the Bridge, Red Hot Chili
Peppers. Uh-huh.
Shameless, Garth Brooks.
Good. What about you, Kenny?
That's good, too.
No idea.
That's too hard, huh?
Yeah.
I literally just came with the first one that came to mind. Oh!
That was my first.
That was my fault this time. Yeah. All right, let's see.
Maybe the Colonel Sanders rendition of the DX theme.
Yeah, you're right. What was that? Thoughts on Lucha Underground, I think I saw.
I haven't seen enough of it.
Yeah, I've only seen
one or two episodes. I like any promotion that gives the boys work, though. So
I watched sort of like seasons, like a season. It was kind of like a half-hour deal where they took all the episodes and they made kind of like a highlight. Yeah. Maybe I think they're about 35 to 40 minutes long, and it was really compelling to watch it in that format. So, mm-hmm. Yeah, I think it's really cool.
I can't say enough good things about Pentagon and Phoenix.
Opinions on Goldberg. Oh, I'm sorry, Cody.
No, were you going to say something? Cross, Pentagon,
Strickland.
They're all great.
They're all amazing,
yeah.
I like watching Jack so much.
Jack Evans?
Awesome.
Oh, I love Jack.
Jack needs a job like at ROH or even here. He's got to...
Yeah, he does.
A lot of people want to know why. What's our opinion on The Undertaker for some reason?
I don't know him.
I've never met him. I don't know him. Actually, I haven't seen him recently either. I didn't watch any of those recent pay-per-views in their completion. So it's tough to really have an opinion. I only remember like the Dead Man of old. Uh-huh. And he always brought it for big matches. What can you say, really?
The only one that really knows me is Cody.
Yep.
The last, like, I feel like the last true locker room leader, like, you'd think be a total hard ass, but was actually super diplomatic and handled things appropriately.
Cool.
Nothing but good things to say about the Dead Man.
Do you guys listen to Fozzy? That's one of the questions.
No.
You know what?
I want to for Chris. But
yeah, there's that one single.
I've heard a couple of them.
I think it was called Enemy.
Yeah, I like that one.
So good.
Enemy.
Yeah.
All that you had.
Nick goes there.
Or something like that.
Yeah. Or something like that.
You and I. Fade away. Yeah. Something like that.
It was really good.
All right, let's see. You guys are asking them way too fast.
Does Cody know that WWE are still selling Stardust toys?
Wow.
I do, because I just got my
royalty. Yeah, exactly. That's what I was about to say.
No problems.
Yeah. No complaints. Yeah. The mutant Stardust figure.
There. Who's our current favorite wrestlers?
Well, they're all in this room.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Let's see.
Let's make it fair. The people that aren't in this room, who are your
Jeff
favorites?
Cobb.
Yep.
Oh, I like Jeff Cobb.
And I was just asking you guys, buddy, yesterday, is this guy any good? I haven't seen him.
Oh, we worked him, right? Yeah. Big guy.
He's strong.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Man, that's hard.
I know.
It's tough because, I mean, I got to say, like.
AJ Styles.
AJ, Sami Zayn, Cesaro. Yep. These guys are all really good.
You're right.
I love watching Ricochet do his crazy stuff.
Oh, I love Ricochet's stuff. Yep.
Yeah. There's no one that comes.
I love Marty Scurll too.
Marty's great. Yeah. Marty's so good.
Again, that guy.
We've gotten to see him.
I want to watch him more. I want to watch.
Personally, we've seen him a lot now at ROH, and he's killing it.
Yeah.
He's getting over with the American audience like that.
Quick. Like these guys that are all coming up that everyone is telling me to watch or that
Dalton's great.
Dalton's great.
Awesome. I watched his entrance yesterday, and it's just so funny, man.
It's so good.
I didn't even care about the match. It's like, who cares. Right. I'm entertained. It's done.
Let's see.
I got one for you, don't Nick.
Oh, go ahead.
Do you guys miss AJ Gallows and Anderson?
Of course.
Of course, they're our buddies.
They're great.
We caught up with AJ a couple months ago and had dinner with him. He's the same AJ. We talked to Gallows and Gunn.
Oh, all the time.
On a weekly basis. Yeah. So they're still our buddies.
I got my little project with Gallows going on in Atlanta.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Cool.
Bulletproof.
I'm asking the questions, guys. Someone asked where I am. I'm looking at it on the screen right here.
A question to me, have I seen my match against Okada yet? No. Still no.
You didn't watch
it? Wow. Still no. No, strangely.
So you pulled like the Rowdy Piper. You had the, what some are calling, greatest match of all time, and you never wanted the...
Yeah, you probably shouldn't watch it.
Yeah. It's
tough.
It'll never live up.
Yeah,
right?
Never will, yeah.
It's strange.
You probably shouldn't watch
it. Even after it felt as good as it did after the fact, immediately after, I was like, oh, thank God, it was
yeah.
It's over. It seemed to have gone over well, like when I was walking the back with you guys.
Seems to.
I remember your initial reaction was like, God, I went so over in time. And Nick, like, what are you talking about? Who can you guys in a classic?
Yeah.
What are you like, what are you talking about? Yeah.
I remember specifically because obviously Matt and I were out there with him. We knew he was gonna hit that crazy moonsault.
Yeah, we were worried about the guardrail.
So after he nailed that, we're like, oh my God, he's got it.
Someone said I had dad reflexes because like you were. Someone said you might have hit your jaw on the thing. I kind of give you a little bit of a
I'm putting a pillow over here so the phone doesn't fall.
Good idea.
And Alan calls you again.
Oh, it's a good one. What's your thoughts on deathmatch wrestling?
I love it.
I love it too.
It's fun to watch.
I do.
I love it too.
It's scary.
I love it for what it is, but I never want to do it.
Yeah.
Good. Yeah.
Yeah.
How about Paige or Bailey joining the Bullet Club? I'm all for females joining the club. Why the
hell?
If the shoe fits.
In my opinion, if any female joins the Bullet Club, speaking of that, it's Candice LeRae.
Yeah.
She could take a beating. She could take a super kick from a shoe that has thumbtacks super glued to the bottom of it. Yeah, so she's welcome to come to the club at any
time. Definitely. But selfishly, I want to work with her as in against
that's
her.
True. Yeah.
So, yeah.
What time is it?
11:53. You want to wrap this up in a few minutes?
Seven more minutes.
Let's say, yeah, 7 or 10, okay. Just because we had some...
What do you think of the Broken Hearties gimmick? I think it's great. I think they reinvented themselves, and they're ahead of everybody else right now.
Stay tuned, because we got some crazy stuff coming up.
Yep.
Matt's amazing.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Genius. Let's see. Checking. Are you guys going to watch Logan next week?
Not next week. Probably when it comes out here, because I'll be here, and I'll use that small amount of spare time I get in one of the small towns to sneak out and watch it. Probably.
I'll watch it on an airplane.
He's not wearing the suit though, huh?
He's just
a shirtless dude again.
I think it's Old Man Logan, but he's never gonna go on. He's been Wolverine. Yeah. If they ever recast it, I'm gonna be heartbroken. So I always thought I'd see him in the yellow.
This guy has a question for the group. And he says it's very important. Dogs or cats?
Dogs.
Neither.
Cats.
I have cats and they're ruining my life.
I got a cat and a dog. Come on, man.
You don't understand.
I'm making requests for you to put that cat in the video more. Yeah. I love your cat.
I am the only one that takes care of them. Oh, I come home from the road, my place smells, I clean up after them, I feed them, no one else helps.
You sure it's not your wife?
So it's almost like I love them so much, but I'm almost resenting them, and it makes me feel bad. Mm. I'm just not an animal person anymore. I think I've grown up into this age now, where like my kids are more...
Kids are animals.
Right. Like, I think after... my kids, I said, right.
Yeah, okay.
I think after these cats, I'm done with animals. I'm sorry. I like going to the zoo, though.
Oh, I love going to the zoo.
Yeah.
A lot. Yeah.
My 3-year-old fed a giraffe the other day. It was awesome.
Oh, that's great.
It was awesome.
Big tongue.
Yeah, crazy. Yeah.
I've kind of fallen in love with capybaras lately. They're like the biggest hamster on the planet. They're like humongous
hamsters.
You're
a big dog guy, Cody,
they like taking like, you know, hot baths and stuff. They're really cute.
Oh, yeah. Speaking of.
There he is.
Show that to the screen right there.
He's real cool.
See, man, a dog like that, man.
Hates Joey Ryan.
Looks magical.
Really crosses his legs when he sits.
Yeah.
Joey do the dick spot with your dog?
We think it's his facial hair, but I've never heard him howl and clear back.
I just got immediate heat from my wife, Dana, for what I said about not taking care
of him. Oh, yeah. I said it.
She says, I'm too busy running Young Bucks merch. And she is. She's got like 100 over 100 open orders right now, and she works her butt off. So I'm sorry, Dana. You do work very hard.
Hey, I am sorry. No, you do great work, and you helped me out too. I'm part of that group as well. Yeah. So thank you very much.
Let's see. A couple more guys.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. I don't know.
I gotta get this back here. Oh, Jesus.
You're trying to find a good one.
If you could have a Falls Count Anywhere match at any location in the world, where would it be?
The place Kenny initially did his thing.
Boat, White House, etc.
Mine would
be where Kenny had his first famous Falls Count Anywhere match on YouTube.
There's no reason why we can't do it.
Oh my God, that'd be awesome.
We
have to do it.
We could actually make that happen.
We have to. Like when the time comes, we have an open schedule. Yeah, man, we should all figure something
that's
out.
Such a good idea.
Oh man,
we can make that happen. As if we can just find a window of time.
Yeah.
Some crazy 6 man or something.
Yeah, because I'm tearing that place down anyway.
Oh, we have to do it. Yeah.
We could destroy it.
And then we can actually, and then we can actually tear it down.
Yeah, yeah. You could tear the house down. Yeah.
Exactly.
Okay.
That's great.
Pineapple on pizzas, yes or no?
I do it.
I'll do it. I'll do
sometimes.
It. Yeah. I'm more of a jalapeno guy.
We had the pineapples in those quesadillas, and I was like, wow, just it seems to work with
that,
so many
the
things.
Hard Rock Cafe.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, the pineapple.
So
yeah.
Good.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a pepperoni guy, though.
Yeah, me too. Yeah. I would gag with the pineapple.
Really?
Yeah, legit.
Would you?
I don't think I could do it.
I could do a slice or two, and then I'm over it.
I don't think I could do it.
Yeah.
Guys, what's the last WWE show you have watched?
I haven't watched.
In its entirety.
Oh, are you kidding?
This question is specifically what, and then there's a second part, but in its entirety, I can't even remember.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. Maybe a Decade.
I just
over
watched
a Decade.
The full Hoosier Dome WrestleMania.
Yeah, you're telling us
the
about
full
that.
Hoosier
Which
Dome
one's
WrestleMania.
That?
Okay, yeah.
Eight, maybe?
Oh, okay. Oh, that's understandable.
But I watched the full thing.
Wow.
Yeah.
Who was on commentary for that one?
It's Bobby and Gorilla.
Oh, right? such great dynamic.
Oh, it's
oh,
that's
probably
favorites. What got you through it.
It's
you know what I mean?
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Flair, Savage.
Yeah.
Centerfold, right. Liz in the pictures.
Yeah. Oh, that's
right. But match in its entirety, if I'm to tell
a
the
match?
Truth,
just
it was AJ versus Cena. Because I wanted to hear what
recently,
all of the
right?
fuss was about.
The Rumble?
It was awesome.
Yeah.
The Rumble one?
Yeah.
I don't even like... It's like, oh, I'm too cool for school. I don't watch WWE. Look at me. I'm a hipster. It's like, no, I just really don't have time.
Yeah.
Or like, when I'm home, I don't want to watch wrestling. Like, I don't know. Like, and if I do, I just want to watch myself because I'm a mark for myself. So.
When you're home or when I'm anywhere, I don't want to watch wrestling. So it doesn't matter where I am. If I have any spare moments, I'm either hanging out with these guys or... I'm trying to catch up on the tons of games that I'm behind in, and I don't want to get left behind in Street Fighter either, so it's like taking care of my body, taking care of myself, my own career, my career with these guys, my level of play in Street Fighter, and then after all that, it's like, you know, whatever game that I enjoy for fun.
I'll watch a show live.
Live wrestling is the best, bro.
Yeah,
live wrestling.
Yeah.
There's nothing like it. And then, like, as far as, like, our act, it's so much better live. Like, if you watch it on tape, it's good, too. But, like, I feel like the Young Bucked act is so much better in person.
Which, sidebar, those What Culture shows are live.
Yeah.
They're
recorded
lives.
On YouTube?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
I believe so.
Cool.
Should be wild.
All right. Well, guys, it's 12 o'clock. Is that it? Or you guys want to do a couple more?
I was thinking maybe give him a couple more minutes because you had some technical difficulties.
Okay.
I actually want to ask this. What is your favorite game to play just for fun? That you're just like not...
Recently, what really was able to take me out of like my world and allow me to sort of insert myself into another one was Resident Evil 7.
Oh, okay.
And
yeah.
That really brought me back to like the feeling of how the first one was when I was just living in it and... even, you know, it was sort of consuming my thoughts throughout my day as well. Just the mystery of it, the intrigue, and, you know, how am I actually going to survive, or how can I increase my, you know, the way I play so that I'm conserving more ammo. And I was so glad Capcom really just scored huge at that one.
Yeah.
A+ in my books if you guys need something to play. Really good, the scariest experience of any game or any movie, anything, any sort of interactive media. It puts any sort of horror movie that's come out in recent memory to shame.
Oh, wow.
It's that good. Like, I watched Don't Breathe, which is a great movie.
Oh,
and
my
scary.
God. It was great movie.
But
great
after playing Resident Evil 7, no reaction. It was like, this is good. It's interesting. But Resident Evil 7 is just so much scarier.
Wow.
And you feel so much more into that universe. Anyway.
I have to play it.
That's that. And I can't wait. The next game that will be hopefully one to take me out of this planet. Is Legend of Zelda come on the Switch?
Okay.
You know, yeah, it's coming soon.
This is an interesting question. Someone says on being the Elite 37, how close was that to reality? That was
100%
reality.
100%.
Yeah,
yep.
That's us being us. Honestly, in a video happened to capture what it's like to be with us for a day. Like honestly,
all those toys that you saw us. Tape.
Yeah, but those are ours.
We literally took those home.
And then you know what didn't make the cut is we went to this place called Hao Ming, which is a great place, and we shopped until we dropped there.
Yeah, we're wearing stuff right now.
I will say,
this whole getup.
Yeah. This actually was a present from a good
friend
of mine.
That's great.
I love it. I've got two of them. Super Nintendo cartridges, Nintendo cartridges.
That's cool.
This guy knows what I like. You're a great friend. Thank you very much, Dan. Yeah, the only thing we didn't take in that video, which I guess you could call fake if you want, we never took that big box home.
That's right.
Oh, yeah. The box.
That's the only thing.
Yeah, we didn't take the box.
We could have filled everything up.
Yeah, it. That's true. Yeah. Actually, it still would have been overflowing. But,
but whenever we go,
that was a little bit of spice for the viewers. Yeah.
Whenever we're out at dinner, I go, hey guys, get whatever you want. It's unlimited.
You kept saying that.
That's real.
Yeah.
I mean, they literally hand us menus. They say, whatever you want, it's unlimited. Keep going. And, like, it's great. Like, we're blessed out here to have these guys take care of us.
Everyone takes care of us here. It's
unbelievable
awesome.
Here in Japan. It's so good. Someone actually asked a question, what's the best part of Japan? And
it's probably
it's the hospitality,
people,
right?
The people. Yeah.
The nicest. The people are sweethearts. They're the best.
When our run's done here, I'm going to miss the people here. So much.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And we're actually, Nick and I are aren't coming back here for a while after this trip, so I'm really going to miss this place. We're going to take a couple months off to try to do business at home with Ring of Honor, make that kind of our top priority for a while. But we're going to miss it. This place is the best. Tokyo Dome Hotel is like a second home to me. So
yeah. Kind of a different question, unrelated. Yeah. Related. Oscar season. What kind of movies would you guys like
it's
to see nominated?
Now.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Like it's happening.
I want to see Moana win.
That movie's awesome.
I didn't see it.
I need to see it.
The Rock is so good.
You know what's good about Moana? It didn't have an agenda.
Yeah,
like,
that's
Zootopia,
true.
Right. Yeah. That did have a huge political agenda.
You want to go
right.
And watch a cartoon movie, Moana, like.
You're right.
That's why I can't see Moana being better than Zootopia. But I haven't seen Moana, so I can't comment.
Moana's awesome. Have you seen Finding Dory?
Oh, no.
I haven't seen that.
Classic.
You're welcome. Song. I showed Adam that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I showed you that too. It was great. Yeah.
Would you like to have CM Punk and the BC?
Yeah.
I think he's the only guy left that I'd probably like.
Yeah, that's
BC.
It.
Yes. Right, is that it?
Yeah. I mean, there might be a couple dudes that just end up in the Bullet Club, but I'm telling you right now, that's not. Probably will just be as a result
Hulk Hogan.
Of booking decisions.
And Hulk Hogan.
Hogan. If that's still an option, Hogan. The only other person I could touch Hogan in terms of like hype factor and someone able to contribute,
you're right.
It's got to be Punk.
I talked to Punk. He's my buddy, and we text every now and then. I'm just name dropping, and everyone's going to call me on that right now. But I told him, whenever you want to come back, please text me.
Yeah.
And we'll make this work out, because I would love to work with Punk. He's one of my favorites all time. What a great talker. Like, I think that's the one thing missing on the indies is guys who can talk like Punk and this freaking guy.
He made me an indie wrestling fan.
You know what? I watched one of your promos, Cody, from ROH. It was so
good. Cool. I texted him. I think I said, you're the best talker I've ever been in the ring.
Yeah.
Was it because I was doing the intro, though?
Maybe because you're putting me over so long.
Oh, right. Yeah.
Oh. That's the best, man.
He's awesome. Yeah.
He's when I got to Louisville, he didn't have to be, because he was, like, the big dog there at OVW, but he was the only one, like, bringing folks in, showing you around.
That's cool.
Helping you out, like,
cool.
Honest, but not a dick about it.
Right.
You know,
That's cool.
Punker special.
That's good to hear.
Maybe a couple more questions and
we're and then we'll wrap it up.
Okay.
So Cody can go to the gym still because he wanted to.
Wanted to? Oh, okay.
I'm here though.
I'm sure. Yeah.
Are you converted, by the way? How'd you like your Vietnamese coffee? Is that your first time?
Oh my gosh.
It's unreal,
and I'd come literally from next door after legit punching the wall. I don't know if you heard it, like 2 or 3 times. Because I couldn't get the coffee to work. I'm not capable.
Yeah, me either.
I did an interview with Kevin Kelly yesterday where I'm
in that white room.
In
the murder room. Where I'm literally just like, blah, 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 because I had no coffee. And
that's
like, halfway during, I was like, please, someone, like,
I'm a different person without my coffee.
Yeah.
I won't even speak in the morning. Like, sometimes I'll wake up and my daughter's trying to talk to me, and I'm just like this. Daddy, why aren't you talking to me? I'm like, I'm sorry, I just haven't had coffee yet. Like, I'm an addict.
My wife gets me these ridiculously oversized mugs. Mm-hmm. So, like, it's never functional to take anywhere. Like, I've got a big Hylian Shield mug, a big Kylo Ren mask.
Oh, that's cool, yeah.
They're like bowls.
Right.
Yeah. I can't go anywhere without
me too. Kenny actually turned me on to this place.
Yep.
He's like, you're a coffee guy, you're going to appreciate this place.
Mm-hmm.
And I fell in love. And then we've shown Adam, my wife loves it.
You guys have probably seen these orange cups.
I surprised Adam this morning. I was like, I got something for you. I knock on his door and I have a chocolate croissant and one of these.
You're a coffee guy, Yeah, but I'm like caffeine across the board. I take a caffeine pill when I wake up. I have two energy drinks. I'll drink coffee throughout the day.
I love it.
He's crazy.
All about it.
I could have coffee, that's it.
I haven't had anything.
We got a couple personal questions to maybe close this out.
Yeah, sure.
I've never had
a... Cole.
Yeah.
What kind of pouches you chew, man?
It varies. I'm a skull guy.
Show the screen.
Yeah, right now, I'm doing... Oh!
You ain't showing him shit! You ain't showing him shit!
Well, this time, my thing broke, but...
What is wrong with this?
Is your phone too big for the tripod?
Maybe. Yeah,
I think it is.
I got the 7.
Let's wrap it up anyway. Go ahead. Yeah, Skull Straight Mint Wintergreen Pouch.
Okay, Cody, where the heck is Brandy, man?
She is sitting at home with Pharaoh right now.
Ooh.
Likely
petting him.
Lightly, no.
Or her. Is it her?
They have a weird interaction. She's likely doing business on her phone and watching The Golden Girls.
Lately I've been going back to watch Full House a lot, to be honest.
They're classics.
Yeah. You watched Fuller House yet?
Not yet. I'm literally starting from season one. I've watched every... I'm almost closing down like the first 7 or 8 seasons of the original.
Oh, wow.
It's been a ton of episodes.
Yeah.
I'm kind of getting sick of the old stuff right now because I want to watch the newer stuff, and now, like, isn't, like, season 2 of Fuller House already out as well?
I really gotta
get up to date.
So those Netflix seasons, they come out all...
Maybe last question that I'll say.
Okay.
In your opinion, the best heel versus heel match of all time. What could it be?
That's a hard one.
Someone once told me, could have been Dave Meltzer, could have been some fans. Uh-huh. They told me it was me versus Naito.
Oh.
Who am I to say that it was?
Let's go with that.
I don't know.
Yeah, that's it.
Let's go with that.
But I'm gonna guess it was probably Hogan versus someone, to be honest.
I can't think of one.
Yeah.
Off the top of my head.
Heels aren't my favorite matches.
Like, it's a tough dynamic.
Yeah, it really is. It's weird. They're always kind of different.
I'm gonna guess probably WWE did something really good with that though.
I had an all bad guy Money in the Bank. One time.
Oh, that's
wow.
Cool.
Yeah.
Did it work out well?
Sandow ended up...
That's pretty cool.
Winning. But the story...
I remember that.
It was one of my favorite matches I've ever been involved with because the audience had to literally pick somebody
to rally behind.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, which one of these dickwads?
That guy became a babyface. It was me.
It was you, okay.
Yeah. How funny. Yeah. That's cool.
Son of a bitch pushed me up the ladder.
You guys have anything?
I think that's it.
Yep.
Okay, then that's it.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you, everybody. Yeah, let's plug some stuff for the love of God.
Please, let's do it.
YoungBucksMerch.com. We have new Elite hoodies. They're freaking sweet. We're almost sold out. We've got like only like 15 left, I think. So grab one of those.
Can't believe
it. Amongst other, you know what else we have coming out soon, actually? And I want to, I'm going to show it. We're going to have some new 8x10 photographs of the Dream Team. We also have these kawaii ones. Those are going to be.
Ooh.
We also have the Elite. And
oh jeez, yeah, we have them on
and
beds.
I'm just gonna rip open this bag. Do it. We're gonna Elite flags. I'm gonna have Kenny sign all of these and Nick.
This is the right way.
Yeah.
Unless we sell these guys like right now, I'm not gonna
YoungBucksMerch.com. We're gonna have plenty of cool things. And then go to ProWrestlingTees.com/YoungBucks. We have like 90 shirts. I'm on top of a bed right now. Everyone else, go ahead.
Yeah,
it's ridiculous.
AdamColePro.com. Yeah. There's ProWrestlingTees.com/AdamCole. And then ROHWrestling.com has some cool Adam Cole stuff on there, too.
Yes, they do.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes, they do.
I do. I'm just going to plug that coffee. Codes.
Yeah.
All right. There it is right there.
It's exceptional. And thank you very much.
You know what? I can also vouch for their coffee lattes as well. I fill my cards for being a frequent customer.
Yeah.
So I get them free. And they're also good.
All right.
Vietnamese is the way to go.
Yep.
And you can also get Kenny shirts at ProWrestlingTees.com.
You can. Yeah. They are available there.
Yeah.
All our shirts.
I'm being humbled.
Yeah. Top guys.
Top guys. Yeah.
I've been humbled by being a top.
You
shirt
know,
as of late.
I've been seeing your shirt a lot.
Yeah.
Cody.
That thing's
yeah,
popular.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The American
a lot.
Has
yeah.
Been, a top seller.
Everywhere we've been going, I've seen
fans. I've seen the American. I've seen the Bullet Club, and I can kind of see the American colors. So I was like, oh, that's the Cody one.
And check out our show tonight on New Japan World.
Yep.
We're
Oh, geez. We're in the main event tonight, right?
Yeah.
We are. Yeah.
And Adam's got a big match tonight.
Big title match.
Yoshihashi.
Yeah, actually two really big matches. Yeah. So,
this is the first time ever.
What time does the show start? 6:30 JST, right?
Yeah.
So what's that?
It's like 3 a.m. or something, Eastern, right, or something like that.
Yeah. Stay up late or check out the replay. NJPWWorld.com. Check us out, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks for the support. Thank you. Subscribe on our YouTube, too, The Elite. And also... I'm just kidding.
All right.
Bye.
Bye. I think